name is Ben Shirley. I am the co-president of the Drum Club.
And my name is Megan Arter, and I'm the other co-president of the Drum Club.
First of all, thank you so much for coming out to our production of A Chorus Line. We would like to advise that all electronic devices should be turned off. They interfere with the microphones, and we don't want to have any sort of feedback tonight, so please and thank you for that.
We also ask that you do not take any flash photography, for it is a big distraction to the people on the stage.
We will have a 20-minute intermission after Act 1, where you can go get refreshments, drinks, food, anything you need to do before Act 2, essentially. And when you come back in, please note that there are no food or drinks allowed in the auditorium at all times.
Next, we would like to thank a ton of people, and the list is so long that I'm not going to say it, but it includes people in the pit that help with the stage direction, the sets, the props, everything.
Get ready for next year, guys, because in the fall, we will be putting on High School Musical, and in the spring, we will be putting on Annie, so it's going to be an exciting year next year, so get ready for that.
And lastly, we would just like to remember, tell you guys that it is a PG-13 show. Just keep that in mind.
Anyway, sit back, relax, and enjoy A Chorus Line.
Two, three, four, five, six.
Diana, your dad's put your tongue again.
I'm sorry.
You, any ballet?
No.
Don't dance. No, don't dance. Next group. Okay, Lori.
The arms are second down fourth. I want to see it. A 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Thank you. Hold it. Stay in the formation. It's good, but just stay. Head back.
Five, six, seven, eight.
Girls first. Number two. Number nine. Number 10. Number 23, Judy Turner. Right. Number 37. 149. 152. 179. Cassie. Other girls, thank you very much for coming. I'm sorry. Boys, number 5, number 17, number 44, 45, 63, 67, and 81. Oh, 84. Other boys, thank you very much for coming. I'm sorry. Lori.
God, I think I got it. I think I got it. I knew he liked me all the time.
Pictures and resumes, please.
Still, it isn't over. It isn't over.
Whoa.
I can't imagine what he wanted.
Start with your name and step forward.
Don Kerr, Kansas City, Kansas.
Next.
Maggie Winslow.
Louder.
Maggie Winslow! Also known as Margaret, Margie, Peggy, all of the above. Whatever, it's real, and I was born in San Mateo, California on a Tuesday evening at 10:17 p.m. August 17th. Oh, and I'm 25.
I'm Mike Costa, used to be Costa Filoni. I was born in Trenton, New Jersey on the 4th of July. 24. Next.
Connie Wong. It's always been Connie Wong. I was born in Chinatown, Lower East Side.
Wait, how old are you? Go on, Miss Wong.
December 5th. 4,642. Fear of the chicken.
Okay, next.
My name is Cindy Kenneth Beckenstein. My Jewish name is Rachmel Lev Yaakov Meyer Beckenstein. My stage name is Gregory Gardner. I'm very East Side. I do not deny it. And I'm 32.
Cassie. Zach, can I talk to you for a minute?
Sure, go ahead.
Well, I meant privately.
Not right now. I'm already running about an hour behind.
Well, I know, but
next.
I'm Sheila Bryant. My real name is Sarah Rosemary Bryant, which I really hate. I was born in Colorado Springs, Colorado, and I'm gonna be 30 real soon, and I'm real glad.
I'm Robert Charles Henry Joseph Mills III. That's my real name too. I was born in upstate New York near Buffalo. I can't remember the name of the town. I blocked it out. I'm 25.
My name is B.B. Benzenheimer, and yeah, I know I've got to change that. I'm 22. I come from Boston, and here I am!
Hi, I'm Judy Turner. My real name is Tina Turner. No, it's Judy Turner. I'm 26. Oh, and I'm from El Paso, Texas.
Good. Next.
Hi, my name is Richie Walters, and I'm 27. I was born on a full moon in Herculaneum, Missouri. And I'm black.
Name's Alan DeLuca. I'm 30 years old, and I come from the Bronx.
Ooh.
Oh, I'm Christine Yurick, Christine Evelyn Yurick, and I'll be 23 on September 1st.
Tell them where you're from.
Oh, and I'm from St. Louis, Missouri. Oh, and my married name is DeLuca.
Oh, I didn't know, Al. Congrats.
Thanks.
Next.
Well, as far as I'm concerned, I'm Valerie Clark. But my parents seem to think I'm Margaret Mary Houlihan.
But couldn't you just die?
I was born in the middle of nowhere, a little town called Arlington, Vermont.
Goodbye.
How old are you?
Old. No, I'm 25.
Mark Anthony, really Mark Philip Vincent Tepore, Tempe, Arizona, and I'm 20.
Oh, Jesus.
And if I get this job, I'll work real hard.
I'm gonna bug you, honey.
Paul San Marco?
That's my stage name. My real name is Efren Ramirez. I come from Harlem. I'm 27.
My name's Diana Morales, and I didn't change it because I figured ethnic was in. I'm 27, you got that? And I was born on a Hollywood bed in the Bronx. Woo!
Go on, Diana.
Go on what? Oh, you want to know the color of my eyes? Or how tall I am? Or how many shows I've been in? I just gave you my picture and resume. Everything you want to know is right there.
Yeah, I know. Now tell me what's not about it.
Like what?
Talk about yourself.
Talk about what?
Tell me about the Bronx.
What's to tell about the Bronx? It's uptown and to the right.
Well, what did you do there?
In the Bronx? Mostly just wait to get out.
Why did you start dancing?
I don't know, I'm Puerto Rican, I have rhythm. I always like to dance. Listen, if you give me a scene to perform, I can act, I can perform. But I just can't talk, please. I'm too nervous.
Look, then relax.
Look, I don't mind talking, it's just that I don't want to go first. Please.
You want this job, don't you?
Sure, I want the job.
Okay, Diana, back in line. Before we do any more dancing, and we will be dancing some more, let me explain something. I'm looking for a strong dancing chorus. I need people that look terrific and that can work well as a group. But there are some small parts that have to be played by the dancers I hire. Now, I have your pictures and resumes, I know what shows you've been in, but that's not gonna help me. And I don't think giving you just a couple lines to read is going to help either. Instead, I think it would be better if I knew something about you. About your personalities. So I'm going to ask you some questions. I want to hear you talk, treat like an interview. I don't want you to think you have to perform, I just want to hear you talk and be yourselves. And everybody just try and relax as much as you can. Sheila?
How many people do you want?
4 and 4.
44?
No, 4 and 4.
4 boys, 4 girls.
Do you need any women?
Okay, Mike, I'll start with you.
Me? Don't you want to start at the end?
No, I'll start with you. Relax.
I could if you started at the end.
What do you want to know?
What do you want to tell me?
I'd like to tell you to start at the end. I can't think of a thing.
Yes, you can.
Look, why did you start dancing?
Oh, because my sister did. I come from this big Italian family. My grandmother was always hanging out a window, leaning on a little pillow, because that's what Italian grandmothers do, they hang out of windows. I was the last of 12. I was an accident. Well, at least that's what my sister told me. Oh, that was your sister, Rosalie. She's the one that started taking dance lessons. My mother would take her every Saturday, and she used to bring me along. I liked going.
How old were you?
4. I sit there all perky and I'm watching sis go pit a pat. Said, I can do that. I can do that. Knew every step right off the bat. Said, I can do that. I can do that. One morning, sis won't go to dance class. I grab her shoes and tights and all. But foot's too small, so I suffer shoes with extra socks. Run 7 blocks in nothing flat. How do I do that? I got to class and had it made. And so I stayed the rest of my life. Oh, thank you, sis. Now I'm very fat. I do this. That I can do. I can do that.
And then everybody started calling me Twinkle Toes.
Did that bother you?
No. I figured let them say what they want.
Yeah, I don't buy that, Mike.
Well, sure it bothered me. I didn't want anybody calling me Twinkle Toes just because it was a couple dance lessons.
Okay, Mike. Back in line. Bobby, you're on.
Well, actually, I don't know how it turned out as heavenly as I did. You see, when I was 5, I was playing with Jax, and the car fell down on my head.
Bobby, are you going to do a routine?
No. Moving along. Let's see. Do you want to hear about all the wonderful and exciting things that have happened to me in my life? Or do you want to know the truth?
I'll take the truth.
Well, to begin with, I grew up in this quasi-middle upper or upper middle class family type home. I could never figure out which, but it was real boring. I mean, we had money, but no taste. You know the type of house?
AstroTurf on the patio. Anyway.
My mother used to love to throw a lot of card parties, and she was one of the foremost rich cheaters in America. My father used to work for this big corporation. They used to send him out to the field a lot to drink. Better that than to find him lying on his office floor. But he was okay. I was the strange one.
How strange? Real strange.
I used to love to give garage recitals bizarre recitals. This one time, I did Frankenstein as a musicale. I spray painted this kid silver all over. They had to rush him to the hospital because he had that thing where your pores can't breathe. Oh, he lived. Because luckily I didn't paint the soles of his feet, and...
Something, what does he want? What does he want? Stories from the past. I better find one fast.
What should I say? What can I tell him?
And as I got older, I kept getting stranger and stranger. I used to love to go to this busy intersection by my house and direct traffic. I just wanted to see if anyone would notice me. And that's when I started breaking into people's houses. Oh, I didn't steal anything. I just liked to rearrange the furniture. And...
And... Orphan at three, mother and dad both gone. Raised by a sweet ex-con. Packed up at home at seven, seriously. Seriously, nothing to obscene. I'd better keep it clean. What should I say? What can I tell him?
School? You want to hear about school? I went to PS shit. You see, I was that kid who was always getting stuffed in the lockers. Not just by the students, but by the teachers too. Oh, and I hated sports. Hated sports, but sports were very big there. I mean, it was Jock City, but I didn't make one team. You see, I couldn't catch a ball if it had Elmer's glue on it. And when my father had to be this big ex-football hero, he was so humiliated, he didn't know what to tell his friends. So he told them all I had polio. On Father's Day, I used to limp for him, and...
How will I begin? And why am I so thin? What should I say? What can I tell him?
And my mother kept saying, if you don't stop setting your brother on fire, we're gonna have to send you away. I was always thinking of these spectacular ways of how to kill myself, but then I realized to commit suicide in Buffalo is redundant. Sheila.
Yes, you want me?
Yes.
Oh, he wants me.
To talk.
Oh, right. Well, what do you want me to talk about first?
Why are you in the business?
Well, I wanted to be a prima ballerina. That light, oh my god, what color is that? Do you have anything softer?
Don't worry about the light.
Thank you.
Just talk.
Well, like I said, I wanted to be a ballerina. Because my mother was a ballerina. Until my father made her give it up.
Sheila, come downstage. Hello, sir.
Can I sit on your lap?
Do you always come on like this?
No. Sometimes I'm aggressive. Actually, I'm a Leo.
And what's that supposed to mean?
It means the other 11 months. You should watch out. I'm very strong.
Maybe too strong.
What? Am I doing something that you don't like? You told us all to be ourselves.
Yes, just tone it down.
Tone what down?
Your attitude. Tell me about your parents.
My parents?
Your father?
Him?
Your mother.
Oh, my mother. My mother was raised like a little nun. She couldn't go out. She couldn't even babysit.
Kayla, don't perform. Just talk.
So then she became a ballerina and she had all of these scholarships and all of that. And then when she got married, my father made her give it up. Isn't this just so exciting? And then she had this daughter, me. And she wanted to make her what she wanted to be. And she was fabulous in the way she did it. Would you like to know how she did it?
Yes, but first, your hair.
What? You don't like it?
No. Let it down.
That's what I've been trying to do. Better?
Better. Go on.
Oh, right. How she did it. Well, first she took me to see all the ballets. Then she gave me her old toe shoes, which I used to run down the sidewalk in. On my toes, at 5. And then she took me to see the red shoes. And I wanted to be like that lady, like that redhead. And when my mother saw that I had to dance, she said, well, you can't dance until you're 8. Well, by then I was only 6, and I said, but I've got to dance. I mean, anything to get out of the house.
What?
Nothing.
What did you say?
I just said I wanted to get out of my house.
Why?
Well, let's face it. My family life was, not good. Daddy always thought that he married beneath him. That's what he said. When he proposed, he informed my mother he was probably her very last chance. And though she was 22, she married him. Life with my dad wasn't ever a picnic, more like a come as you are. When I was 5, I remember my mother dog carrying down in the car. I knew the day where he hurt, but it wasn't something he wanted to discuss. He wasn't born. Well, not to her. Well, not to us.
Everyone is beautiful at the ballet.
to save their marriage, but when my father came to pick my mother up from the hospital, he said,
well, I thought this was going to help, but I guess it's not.
Oh, anyway, I did have a fantastic fantasy life. I used to dance around the living room with my arms up like this. My fantasy was that it was an Indian chief, and he'd say to me, Maggie, do you want to dance? And I'd say to him, Daddy, I would love to dance.
She's doing her best. Jingle bells, jingle bells.
Jingle bells, jingle bells. It really blows my mind.
She gets depressed.
But what I lack in pitch, I sure make up in
power.
And all my friends say I am perfect for the show.
Dance!
You guys are coming in there.
Dance!
I'm a birdie on the
wing.
But when I begin to
chirp,
they say who's a little?
Twerp.
Going pong instead of
wing.
And when Christmas comes and all my friends go
rambling,
it is so disheartening.
Ding.
It is so disquieting.
Ding.
It is so discouraging.
Jing.
Darling, please stop
answering.
Ring. See, I really couldn't.
Sing.
I could never really.
Sing.
Back in line. Mark, I get the feeling that most of you always knew what you wanted to do. Me? I didn't. I was just a kid for a while. Oh. Then one day, well, my father had this fabulous library in the back of the house. And when I was about 11, I guess, I found this medical textbook that had pictures of the male and female anatomy. I used to read that book a lot. I thought it was pretty interesting.
Were you interested in medicine, or did you just like the pictures?
Well, actually, I...
Hello, 12.
Hello, 13.
Hello, 9.
Change is over.
Next day I went to a doctor down the block, sure enough, acute appendicitis. They rushed me right to the hospital. Well, I figured this book would cover everything the rest of my life. And then, when I was 13, I had my first wet dream. So I went right back into the book. Milky discharge, milky discharge, milky discharge, milky. Gonorrhea! I was in shock! Gonorrhea! Before I even started, I was terrified. I couldn't tell my mother I had gonorrhea. So the book said to drink a lot of water.
Is that all the book said?
No! Take penicillin, strepto, something or another. But I couldn't do any of that unless if I told somebody. So all I could do was drink the water, and I drank like 20 glasses a day for 3 weeks. I almost drowned. Then I went to confession, and I told the priest that I had gonorrhea, and he was in shock too.
Who have you been with, my son?
Nobody. Nobody.
Then how can you have gonorrhea?
Well, I told him the book's diagnosis for milky discharge, and he set me straight. That's the only time church has ever really helped me out. Well, I was
4'10". Thank you.
told me. No dice, you'll get lost on the football field. The pom-poms are bigger than you. I spent my whole childhood waiting to grow.
Boobs! When am I gonna grow boobs?
Secret. My whole life was a secret.
One little fart! And they called me stinky for 3 years!
Ah!
Chicken.
So I got caught, but I don't look it, and I shouldn't knock it, because I've always been able to work. From the time I was 5 in King and I, up till now, I've never stopped, because whatever I am. So excited, because I'm going to go to the High School of Performing Arts. I mean, I was dying to be a serious actress. Anyway, it's the first day of class, and our teacher, Mr. Karp. Oh, Mr. Karp. Anyway, he puts us up on stage with our legs, one back of another, and he says, okay, we're going to do improvisation. Now, you're on a bobsled, it's snowing, and it's cold. Okay, go. Every day, for a week, we try to feel the motion. Sad one.
The summer I turned 15, I lied about my age so I could join AGFA.
You know, the nightclub union, cause I could make $60 a week working these strip joints outside of Kansas City. I worked this one club for about 8 weeks straight, and I really became friendly with a stripper. Her name was Lola Torres, and her dynamic twin 44s. She really took to me. I mean, we did share the only dressing room, and she did a lot of dressing. Anyway, she used to come and pick me up and drive me to work nights. Well, the neighbors would all be hanging outside their windows, and she'd drive up in her big pink Cadillac convertible and smile. I'd come tripping out of my house with my little tuxedo on and my tattoos in my hand, and we'd drive off down the block with her long blonde red hair.
Are you well? Goodbye, 13. Hello.
Big hot romance you were having, right? In reality, though, she was going with this.
Little brat! That's what my sister was! A little brat! And that's why I shaved your head! I'm glad I shaved your head! But then my father lost his job, so we had to leave El Paso, and we wound up in St. Louis, Missouri. Well, it was the first thing from my mind to be a dancer, but my mother would embarrass me, so when she comes to pick me up at school with all the screaming yellow girls in their hair, no matter how ashamed of your own mother.
Did any of you ever practice kissing with another girl? So that when the time came,
thing in school was every time the teacher called on me, I'd be hard. Really, I'd have to lean up against my desk like this, and the teacher would say, stand up straight. I can't, I have a pain in my side, stand up straight. Or walking down the hall, you'd have to walk like this, with all your books stacked up in front of you.
Yeah, I thought it was just me. I thought it was a sex maniac.
You are.
I did too.
I mean, it didn't go down for 3 years.
And the bus was the worst. I just look at a bus and bingo. And then there was the time I was making out in the backseat with Sally Ketchup, and I was feeling her boobs. And after about an hour or so, she said, ooh, don't you wanna feel anything else? And I suddenly thought to myself, no, I don't.
Did that come as a surprise to you?
I guess it was the first time I realized I was homosexual, and I got so depressed because I thought being gay meant being an outcast all the rest of my life, a bum. And I thought, gee, I'll never get to wear nice clothes, and I had this really nice pair of cotton pink African pants.
Goodbye.
day after I turned 18, I kissed the folks goodbye, hopped on a Toroway's bus, and head for the big bad apple. June Allison, right? Because I wanted to be Rockette. And let me get one thing straight. I've never heard about the red shoes. I've never seen the red shoes. I didn't give a shit about the red shoes. I wanted to be a Rockette because a girl from my town, Luella Heiner, had actually gotten an application in New York City. And she was a Rockette. Anyway, she came home one Christmas and they threw her a parade. A damn parade! I had to stand outside in the rain for 2 hours twirling a friggin' baton. Unfortunately, though, she got knocked up over Christmas. Merry Christmas! And never made it back to Radio City. Well, that was my plan. New York, New York, here I come! Only there was one minor problem. You see, I was ugly as sin. I was ugly, skinny, homely, unattractive, and flat as a pancake. You get the picture? You see, I get off the bus in my little white shoes, and my little white tights, and my little white dress, and my little ugly face, and my long blonde hair, which was natural at the time. I looked like a friggin' nurse. I get off the bus with $87 in my pocket and 7 years of tap and acrobatic experience. I could do a 180-degree split and come up tapping the Morse code. Well, with that kind of talent, I just figured the mayor would be standing there waiting for me at Port Authority, right? Wrong. It took me 6 months to even get an audition. Well, finally the big day came, and I show up at Radio City Music Hall with my little red patent leather tap shoes, and I did my little tap routine. And then this man actually comes up to me and goes, "Can you do fan kicks?" Well, sure, I can do terrific fan kicks, but they weren't good enough. Of course, what he was trying to say, it was the way I looked, not the fan kicks. So I said, "Screw you, Radio City and the Rockettes! I'm gonna dance on Broadway!" Well, Broadway, same story. I mean, every audition, I dance circles around the other girls and still end up in the alley with the other rejects. But after a while, I did catch on. I mean, I saw what they were hiring. I also swiped my dance card after an audition once, and on a scale of 10, they gave me, for dance, 10, for looks, 3. Well, dance 10, looks 3, and I'm still on unemployment, dancing for my own enjoyment. Fight it, kid, fight it, kid. Dance 10, looks 3, you'd like to die. Left the theater and called the doctor for my appointment to buy this and that. Bought myself a fancy pair, tightened up the derriere, did the nose with it, all that goes with it, this and that. Got the bingo bongos done. Suddenly I'm getting national tours. This and that won't get you jobs unless they're yours. Didn't cost a fortune neither. Didn't hurt my sex life either. Flat and sassy, I could get the strays and losers. Beggars really can't be choosers. That ain't a kid, that ain't a kid. Fix the chest. Life turned into an endless medley of G. It had to be you. Why this and that? Where the cover once was bare, now you knock and someone's there. You have got to pay top to bottom. Hey, it's a guess. Just a dash of silicone. Shake your new maracas and you're back. This and that will change your life. Nation. I heard that, bitch. I didn't want them like yours. I wanted them in proportion. Well, you got what you paid for. I wouldn't mind having just one of yours. Go out and buy them. Have it all done.
I take my word.
Paul.
Sir?
Would you step out of the blank, please? When did you start dancing?
Oh, not until very late.
Why?
I don't know. I just didn't.
Well, okay, what did you do?
Nothing much.
Come on, Paul, you must have done something. How old were you when you started dancing?
16.
Okay, so what did you do up until the time you were 16? What was your family like?
We were close.
Close? Okay. Brothers? Sisters?
Two sisters. One died when I was 14.
How?
How? Do we really have to talk about that? Why do we have to talk about that?
Lori, can we please sit down?
Yeah, Zach, can the kids sit down now?
Oh, and smoke? Can the adults please smoke now?
Yeah, sure. Then we're gonna have a break out in the hall. Paul, we'll try this again later. Cassie, would you stay on stage, please?
Well, this audition is really interesting, isn't it?
Yeah. What are you doing here?
What do you think? I need a job.
In the chorus.
Zach, I'd love a part, of course. But I'll take what I can get.
You're too good for the chorus, Cassie.
Too good? I did a couple of dance parts. So what?
You were featured. Look, you stopped two shows cold. Your career was going fine here in New York.
I can't get a job, Zach. God, you sound like all my friends. My fans. Acting like I'm some star and I don't know it, and the truth is I never even came close. And nobody has the guts to tell me. Well, it'd be nice to be a star, but I'm not. I'm a dancer.
Give me somebody to dance for. Give me somebody to show. Let me wake up in the morning to find I have somewhere exciting to come.
Okay, you're going through a slow period. It happens to everyone. Something will, you know, happen.
And that's what I kept telling myself in California. And I kept telling myself that and telling myself that. Well, nothing will happen. I can't act.
What?
I can't act. And there I am in California, supposed to be this actress. Well, it didn't take me long to figure out that I can't act. It didn't take Hollywood long either.
You didn't work out there?
Sure. I got a rotten part in a so-so film. Part of it ended up getting cut, thank God. I was a go-go dancer in the TV movie of the week. Let's see. Commercials. I almost got to tweet a roll of toilet paper. But I lost out in the final. Isn't that something? 17 years in the business and I flunked out of toilet paper squeezing. I was a dancing band-aid. That was fun. We had an earthquake. I got a terrific tan and you must have heard
that. I did hear you were going out with some, they call it, big agent, running around, carrying on, being a bit wild.
Well, when you're a woman of leisure, what more is there to do but run around and get a bit wild? Not to mention getting fat and going crazy. Which is why I came back to New York. And why I'm here today. That old dear, little pussycat, I need a job.
To have something that I can believe in. To have something to be. Choose me.
Look, I just can't see you dancing in the chorus, Cassie.
Why not?
Okay, look, do you want money? You can just call my business manager.
Well, sure, I need money, but I don't need a handout. I need a job. I need a job and I don't know how to say it. Do you want me to say it again?
No.
Good. Then I got that far. Look, I haven't worked in 2 years. Not really. And there's nowhere else for me to go. So I'm putting myself on the line. I'm putting myself on your line. I don't want to wait tables. And what I really don't want to do is teach other people what I should be doing myself.
me a place to fit in. Help me return to the world of the living by showing me how to begin.
No, I'm not!
Yes, you are!
Cassie,
let's just keep this business, okay?
Well, why else is anyone here, Zach? For business. That's why I'm here today. For work.
Well, you know what? You shouldn't have come. Look, you don't dance like anyone else. You don't know how.
But I did it before, and I can do it again. You're not even giving me a chance. Please, just let me try.
Excuse me. Do you want the kids back now?
No. I haven't learned the lyric to that combination you did earlier. Oh, and bring Paul in.
Girl, learn the lyric.
Thank you.
Wanted to see me, sir?
Yeah, Paul. Listen, I really like the way you dance. No, I'm serious. So, I thought we'd try this again. For one thing, if you're gonna change your name, why go from a Puerto Rican name to an Italian one?
Because I don't look it. I mean, people would tell me all the time, you don't look Puerto Rican, you don't look Puerto Rican. So I changed it.
So you figured you looked Italian?
No, I just wanted to become somebody new. So I became Paul San Marco.
Well, why did you want to become somebody new?
Why? Well, I'm not exactly proud of my past.
Well, who is? But that's what the word means, Paul, past.
Well, that might be easy for you to say.
Okay, wait a minute. Look, what made you start dancing? Your parents?
What do Puerto Ricans know about musical theater? Now they have Channel 47. Then they didn't have anything. My father loved movies, and he would take us all the time. He would work late at night, he'd come home, and he would take us to 42nd Street, and we'd go in one movie and out to another, and... I don't know, I liked movie musicals.
How old were you?
7 or 8.
On 42nd Street.
Yeah. Yeah, it was a trip.
Go on.
Well, I would have to move to the front of the theater because I couldn't see the screen. I wear contact lenses now. But then I didn't have anything, so I'd have to move up front. And these strange men would come and sit beside me and... I didn't tell anyone. I didn't think it mattered.
Why didn't it matter?
Why?
Okay, look, Paul, if this is too rough for you, I have your picture.
No! No, that's okay. From seeing all of those movie musicals, I loved dancing in the street, and I would get caught all the time. God, it was embarrassing. I was always trying to be Sid Charisse, which I don't exactly understand now, or even then, because I just wanted to be an actor. My cousin told me, you'll never be an actor. I knew she was telling me this because I was such a sissy. I mean, I was terribly effeminate. I always knew I was gay, but that's not what bothered me. What bothered me was that I didn't know how to be a boy. One day I looked at myself in the mirror and I said, you're 14 years old and you're queer. What are you going to do with your life? At that point, I was going to Cardinal Hayes High School. There were nearly 3,000 boys there. I mean, I had no protection. I couldn't be charming in homeroom with all the tough guys so they could fight my battles for me, not like in my other schools. I liked school,
But my grades just got so bad, and every time that I knew the answer, I wouldn't raise my hand because I was afraid they would all just laugh at me. And they would whistle at me in the hallways. And it was awful. It was just awful. I finally went down to my principal, and I said, I'm a homosexual! Well, it was a Catholic school. At the age of 15, you didn't just say that. So he asked me, would you like to see a psychologist? And I did. And then he told me, I think you're very well adjusted for your age, and I think you should quit school. So I did. I didn't want to. I just couldn't take it. See, when I really quit school, what I was really trying to figure out was how to be a man. And since then, I found out that, well, I am one. You know, there's a lot of people in this world that don't actually know how to be a man. And I was doing it all wrong. I was trying to be butch. Well, anyway, I started hanging around 72nd Street with all these freaky people, but I was only trying to do it to figure out exactly what I was. I heard the Jewel Box Review was holding auditions for the drag show. And I went. I mean, from all those years dancing in the street and acting like Sid Charisse, I had this fabulous extension. I mean, I could turn anything my first audition. But the producers came up to me and said, you're too lanky to be a boy. Would you like to be a pony? Well, I said, what's that? A girl. What would I have to do? And they asked me, show us your legs. Well, I have hair on my legs. And they said, that's okay. Come upstairs with us. So I followed them up, and they hiked up these dungarees and high heels and nylon stockings, and it was really freaky. It was amazing. I followed them back downstairs, and the producer said, oh my, you have wonderful legs. And I said, really? Terrific. You know, thinking about all this is so bizarre. I mean, this was all a lifetime ago. I was just barely 16. Oh, and then there was this whole thing, you know, about hiding it from my parents. Because I would have to bring home all this stuff. High heels, makeup, earrings. My mother would find it all the time. But I just told her, there's a girl on the show, and she doesn't want her parents finding out, so I'm holding it for her. My mother believed me. Well, finally, I was in show business. I mean, it was the asshole of show business, but it was a job. I had friends, but everything just got so demeaning, and everybody there just had no dignity, and they just called themselves freaks, and I don't know, there was just something about it that didn't sit well with me, so I left. Oh, I muddled around for a while. I was a busboy, I was a waiter, but without an education, it's really tough to find a job. So when the Jewel Box called me and asked if I'd come back, I went. Well, we were doing shows at the Apollo Theater on 125th Street. We were doing four shows a day and a movie. And we were just about to go on tour. And my parents wanted to come to the theater and say goodbye and drop off my luggage, but after the show. After. Well, we were doing this Oriental number, and I looked like Anna Mae Wong. I mean, I had these two great big chrysanthemums on either side of my head and this huge headdress with gold balls hanging off of it. As I was walking down the steps for the finale, I look at the doors and who do I see standing there? My parents. I mean, they got there way too early, and I freaked. I didn't know what to do. My mind was racing, so I thought, oh, I know. I'll just walk right past them really quickly, just like everyone else, and they'll never notice me. So I took a deep breath. I started down the stairs. And just as I passed my mother, I heard her say, "Oh my God, Paul." I died. I mean, who wouldn't? But I couldn't just stop. I had to keep going for the finale. So after that, I got changed and took off all my makeup. And I walked back downstairs and I found my parents standing with all these. My parents walked up to me and they said, "Please eat. Make sure you're right. And take care of yourself." After that, my father went to the producer and he said, "Please take care of my son." First time my father ever called me.
I don't want anyone to catch my eye. Now, Lori, review it.
The starting position is turned in third. Hips and shoulders on the diagonal. Elbows up, chest up, chin up, eyes front. Ready? A 5, 6, 7, 8. One, change. Walk, walk, point, 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 step, kick. Okay, try it again. From singular position. And
singular position.
Step and step right.
After the grapevine step, the hat comes down on two.
Yeah, hat's down on two.
Excuse me, but when does the hat go up? On six. Five, six.
All right, this is important. Lori has the exact style I'm looking for. Very 30s. Okay, let's do this again. A five, six, seven, eight, a one.
And flip.
That's it. Touch the head.
Three, four. You'll never be lonely with you, no.
ahead do you think you can go back when you're 32?
My sanity.
Yes, you can't do it.
But I didn't. I pulled in again like everybody else.
Yeah, I know. To be perfectly honest, I couldn't stand it.
You know, that's your problem. Why? Because you took me out of the course in the first place? Does that make you feel like some kind of failure?
Why did you leave me?
So we are going to get
it. Yeah, back. Why did you leave me? I came home one night and you were gone.
Why, Zach, you noticed.
Very funny.
You already left me weeks before.
Left? Cassie, I thought we were leaving together.
Sharing an apartment, maybe. No, in the real sense of the word, left. You left. Well, you were madly in love again, and I was...
I wasn't, you know I wasn't. I was directing my first play.
And you were in love with it. It opened the only world that means anything to you.
Cassie, you know how much that meant to me. Christ, if I didn't just start playing and pull it off, it meant I wasn't going to be... It meant I wasn't going to be making up dance moves the rest of my life.
You were never going to be making up dance moves the rest of your life. You were going to make sure you did it all. Direct, choreograph, plays, movies, musicals. You know, I knew you loved your work, but you really get off on it, don't you?
Yeah, I guess I do. Look, you didn't seem to mind it when we were working together. I don't like it when you weren't that.
I didn't mind being a part of your work. I love you, I could have handled that. It was not being a part of your life that got to me. And not being able to fuck with you, which is what you wanted, I knew you did. You wanted me to be a star. I was a good dancer, but you just
wanted
me to be-
Well, what's wrong with that? Why shouldn't you be? When I got out of the course, I pulled myself up.
Not a decision, not a disease. God, good, better, best, I hate it. How can you stand it? Are you going to go from one show to the next, directing and choreographing 24 hours a day for the rest of your life? And you're not even doing it for yourself. You don't get to prove something. Like I was. I just had to prove it to you, to keep you, to please you, to get you back. But I don't want to prove anything anymore. I want to do what I love as much as I can for as long as I can. But at least now I'm doing it for me. What are you doing it for?
One. Singular station.
I'm sorry, I have no right to judge.
One. Really complication.
Why are we doing this? I mean, we must be over this by now, aren't we?
I am.
One smiling, suddenly nobody else.
Is this what you want from me, Cassie? Is this what you really want to do?
Thank you. movie star. Then I can be a movie star. What am I doing in show business?
Okay, everyone stay tight. I'm going to put you in a couple now. First, let me see. Don, Sheila, Bobby, Phoebe, and you couple to that right there. No, someone's from another side of the voice. Boys, we're going to stage a bit. Diana, Val, stand by. Okay. A 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, try to stay on beat. Show me your best smiles. I remember the combination.
It's as if we all
What do you do?
Well, I'll tell you. See, I get scared too. I mean, I love being in this business, but at some point you gotta think to yourself, hey Richie, you've been doing this for 8 years now. Where's it gotten you?
A lot of people are realizing that and getting out of the business fast.
There's no security in dancing.
But wait a second.
No promotion and no advancement.
If you're looking for that type of security, forget it.
It's not just that.
Well, what then?
I could do without that. But shit, it's not working anymore.
Tell me about it.
It's true.
Sure it is, but isn't that happening to everybody?
Well, please, I don't want to hear about that.
Don't
worry, honey. It's not.
They're not going to take rehearsals like they used to.
Yeah, but even if they did, even if you've got the show, it's going to close one day. Nothing runs forever, right?
Yeah, but that's just the way it is.
And you have to start all over again. The only course line you can depend on in this business. What I was going
to do. Give me a break.
But don't you want to do something more than just dance in the chorus?
Gee, I just want to get in one. Like,
well, I just want to be something other than the short brunette second from the end. Not that I want to be a star or anything.
Hell, I do.
Oh, please. Everybody in this whole damn country wants to be a star. Okay, I admit it. I want to be the next Gwen Verdon.
She dances.
I know. Don't you just love her?
No, I mean, what do you do when you can't dance?
Who cares? I don't care if I never dance another step as long as I live. I'd be happy just going to Hollywood and replacing Jill St. John.
Big deal, right?
Well, I can dream, can't I?
Yeah, but dreams don't take on that.
So? I'll find someone who can.
That's the thing that gets me. A girl can always get married.
Hey, she didn't say anything about marriage.
And another thing.
Oh, what? Please. I don't know if I can take it.
These bodies don't last forever.
I can't take it.
We're no better off than athletes.
Well, I can't deal with any of this right now. I try to keep on kicking these legs as long as I can, and,
well, when I can't, I'll just find something else.
Right! So you get into acting!
No! Yeah.
No! You love it! I mean, it's fabulous to find out that you can talk, too. That's what I'm into. I'm not very good, but I'm getting better!
There's no alternative. Just get me through the day, one day at a time. You got to be into it.
Listen, we all share the same way, and if we didn't, we wouldn't be here. But I got a wife and two kids, and it's all about paying the bills now and getting the kids through school. As much as I love dancing and theater, I have to go where the money is.
What do you do?
I'd like to stay in the business. Stage managing and maybe someday directing.
Hello.
I always have to see, I guess.
I can't think of anything else I do.
Alright, well, if we all had to pick another career, come on, pick a career. What would you like to be when you grow up?
Young.
I know what I want to do. If I know that one night when I was stronger than the close, I can finally get off my dieting. Then I'm going to get in a car with my husband, drive up to our 50 acres in Vermont, have a bunch of kids, and dance in the kitchen cooking and enjoy getting fat.
That sounds nice. Except for the fat part. But yeah, I'd like that. Not right away.
Listen, all I want to be is just happy.
Come on, aren't you happy? Guys, I sit around and I get depressed and think about all this stuff too. Then I meet somebody and they say, hey, you dance on Broadway, how fabulous. You got somewhere, you're something. And Christ, I just get this feeling inside. Because I remember when I used to watch all those girls come out of that stage door. With their makeup and their hair. And I think to myself, I'll never be that old. I'll never be that old. I'll never be old enough to come out of that stage door. But damn it, I did. And I've gotten this far. And I'm not giving up now. That's what I used to say. I mean, I'd say I've got to be a ballerina by the time I'm 18. Well, then I found out I should be a musical comedy. Okay, fine, I'll be a chorus girl. But I've got to be playing parts by the time I'm 21.
You did that too? Give yourself a time limit?
I still do it. Exactly. And then you're 25. And how many years do you have left? I mean, I'm 30. Do I have like 3-4 years? I mean, maybe if I get my eyes done, but I don't want to be on that level any longer. And just recently, I don't know, I've been thinking about opening up my own dance studio. But I don't know about that. I'm like,
popping up? Am I growing up?
I don't know. That's just it. Nobody knows. It's just something you're going to have to figure out.
Right. But if today were the day you had to stop dancing, how would you feel?
Kiss today goodbye.
Glad we are going to be working together.
Rinkle, wrinkle,